Misfit Nation.
Live, pal.
What are you gonna do?
Told you. We're gonna hang out.
Misfit.
You watch a movie?
It is the Misfit Nation.
Gonna take some pictures.
Welcome to the show.
All right, 3, 2, 1, go.
Hey, everyone, this is Harrison Young, host of Topic Time. And I was just intermingling with my friend, Christian the Don of Misfit Nation. And we have met the minds, and the minds are there.
Perfect.
For the latest in wrestling news, previews, commentaries, debates, this is the most dangerous podcast in sports entertainment.
Resounded on. Bomba.
They are the Kayfabe Cartel.
You want to be a friend of the cartel?
You can join the cartel on YouTube at Kayfabe Cartel. Oh yeah.
When I started this show, I said to myself, I thrive in Shark Tank environments. And my point is to anybody, don't jump into the fucking Shark Tank unless you're ready to swim with sharks.
Dangerous. We must get ready for it.
The Misfit Nation.
Misfit Nation.
Misfit Nation.
The Misfit Nation.
Misfit Nation.
The Misfit Nation.
Misfit Nation.
Misfit Nation.
Misfit. Don't make me wake this baby. She don't need to see what I'm about to do. Quit crying, bitch. Why you always make me shout at you? How could you just leave me and love him out the blue? What's the matter, Kim? Am I too loud for you? Too bad, bitch. You're gonna finally hear me out this time. At first, I'm like, you wanna throw...
R.I.P. O.J. Simpson. I thought it was appropriate.
I don't know how to...
Well, I don't correlate.
That song is literally like... there. I mean, it deviates a couple times, but it's literally the story of O.J. Simpson.
Yeah. So long, bitch, you did me so wrong.
In his mind.
Yeah.
I mean, I don't know if she, you know, was worth slaughtering into pieces, but, you know, we'll get to that in a little bit. Welcome to the show episode. I think it's 306.
Yeah.
I think we're at 306, the most dangerous podcast. Sorry. I wasn't ready whatsoever.
Jeez Louise.
Son of a bitch. America's most dangerous podcast, ladies and gentlemen. The Misfit Nation podcast that makes me America's most dangerous host. Krishan the Don. Follow me on X. At Krishan the Don.
That was like... J. Jameson corny.
It's your boy Skrill. You can follow me on Twitch, Skrillkill, SKRILLKIIL.
Is that with his Navy boy salute that he does every fucking week? Fucking JFK, wrong hand.
Is it my turn?
Yeah.
Oh, yeah. It's your boy Wonder. What you gonna do, brother? If you don't follow me on all social media platforms at I Am Wonder, IAMWUNDA. And if you need anything customized, holla at me.
How does he get two?
TREDEZ Customs with S. Oh, yeah.
That's not even fair.
Why did he get two?
I gotta say, the NWO, that Hogan.
Best time of Hogan and NWCW right here.
Yeah, yeah.
That's a spray paint. And he said
it's signed by Hogan.
And it's signed by Hogan.
Now, did Hogan also do the NWO spray paint?
Yeah.
You're kidding me.
I kid you not.
Oh, that's awesome. Is that
I got the COA right here to prove it.
Look at that. Mm. I gotta ask it again. Is that abbreviated for N-word?
Yeah. He said we niggas for life when he signed it.
Look at that.
We niggas for life.
Interesting. That's very nice. Yeah. Your belt collection is getting insane.
Yeah, it's getting up there. Like, you might have a problem, actually.
Definitely. Definitely.
No, I don't have a problem.
I think he does. All right, well.
My Paul Heyman Fungo Pop's coming in tomorrow.
Well, you know, he doesn't have a problem. At least anymore.
Oh,
the juice.
The juice.
The juice.
He had 99 problems, but his life's not one right now. God
damn. Well, he had 98 because he took care of the bitch.
Oof. Holy shit.
And damn. Yeah, I mean, OJ Simpson got away with murder, right? That's kind of he had a legendary football career, but he's known as the famous guy that got away with murder.
Hey, allegedly.
Allegedly.
Hey, man.
What's wrong with that?
Let me tell you something. If I go on trial for murder and I get away, I'm not going to write a book that says, hey, if I did this shit, this is how I do it.
I mean,
and it's almost verbatim exactly how it happened.
I mean, I
except
would.
Except in his version, he blacks out. During the murder, hey. Which is probably what he really did. That's why he couldn't write it.
I'd write a book too afterwards. Put the same title and everything.
Didn't he also say that there was somebody with him in his story?
Hmm. Yeah.
I think somebody named Charlie or something like that.
Yeah. It was just code for AC.
It was just code exactly. for Rob.
Exactly. Who was really there too?
It was code for Rob Kardashian.
Mm. Now that guy.
He's the real. He's the real deal. Bitch.
Okay,
he's Saul.
He's Saul Goodman.
Yeah, he was in that. Well, no, actually, it was Cochran that was Saul Goodman in that situation. And actually, that whole situation right there was sort of, I think, what sparked the entire the justice system we see today. Like, all right, do you know that the jurors have come out since then? I'll play the video so we have some evidence behind this.
I'm sure they were pressured. You didn't have to tell
me. No, they weren't even pressured.
Really?
They, themselves said that we did it because...
Because of racial inequality?
Yes.
Oh, my God.
It was a response to Rodney King.
Oh, so because Rodney King got his ass whooped... By some cops. We're gonna let a murderer on the loose
for drunk driving.
What the fuck kind of backwards shit is that?
Yeah, but how is that any different from what happens today?
You're
right. With black folks, they let fucking murderers go free because of they don't want the prisons to be filled with black folks.
Juice lived a good life, bro. That's crazy.
Listen, we'll get to it because Juice actually did live a really good life. He was ostracized a little bit, but...
A little bit. Nigga went to jail for a couple of years for stealing his old shit back.
Let's be real, though. Even though it was probably never going to work, he did do a really good job at trying to assimilate back. And he never acted any different
Because the bitches love the juice, man.
That's what I'm saying. That's he never changed.
As long as the bitches love me.
You gotta appreciate it.
You gotta respect something in there, right?
Yeah.
My bitches love me.
This is the jury.
This is a juror?
This is the one of the jurors.
Can fuck about y'all hate as long as my bitches love me.
Do you think that they're members of the jury that voted to acquit OJ because of Rodney King?
Yes.
You do?
Yes.
How many of you think felt that way?
Oh, probably 90% of them.
Jesus Christ.
Man, this is a black woman 90%. Talking.
Oh, that's all you had to show me. That's all you had to show me.
Oh, 90% of the black women there?
I had no idea that was the jury of his peers. I didn't know.
Oh, yeah, there were black women on the jury.
Okay.
Yeah. I look at their faces. Fan impartial, my ass.
We's gonna tip the scale of justice, always.
We must protect our kings at all costs.
Every time a bit of evidence came out, they were like,
not my OJ.
Not my OJ.
Yeah, forensics, fucking OJ's cuts, everything. And then what? They were the ones that as soon as he couldn't fit the glove on, they were like,
man. See, it don't fit.
There you go.
That's all we needed to know, baby.
You know, his hands may have been swelling that day due to him not taking his medication for diabetes.
Also, you gotta love OJ's acting on the...
I'm really trying, guys. I'm really trying. It shit don't fit, man. And that's the glove y'all said he did it with? That's crazy. It don't fit my way. Hand.
And then he had a rubber glove on top of it, though. Like a surgical glove. Yeah, that was a bad move on the prosecution letting him try on that glove. Have you ever watched The People versus O.J. Simpson?
Is that the one with Cuba?
With Cuba?
I did not watch that shit.
Yeah. Who's involved in the P. Diddy situation. We never talked about him.
Oh, yeah, that's true. I did see that story. On the boat?
One of America's finest actors.
I could definitely see Radio doing some stupid shit like that.
Only for playing a retard.
And Trey in Boys in the Hood.
Yeah, you can't take Trey.
Black Cinematics.
Well, let's.
Oh my god!
Yeah, it doesn't count. They fucking put two B movies on the same level. They fucked themselves.
Boys in the Hood. That's crazy.
That's their fault. At least there's some standards in white cinema.
No,
the Naked Gun movies.
Y'all make all your movies cross gender. Next one, look at Ghostbusters, a fucking chick flick. Now
that's true.
You're right. I don't claim white whiteness anyway. Because yeah, then you're claiming a lot of liberals.
Free Guy was a pretty good white movie.
Look at Ocean's 12, bunch of bitches.
Yeah, that sucked. Well, Ghostbusters, they tried to make it black women, right?
No, was there just
a black woman?
It was a black woman.
Ah, okay. All right. Always has to be one.
There's always one.
Just one.
Liberals like their tokens.
Diversity.
OJ Young Chance PA. OJ lived one of the greatest lives to me. We forgot he got locked up for stealing his own stuff back. Yeah.
Nah, I just said that. I didn't forget that shit.
I did.
That shit was crazy.
I mean, but listen, OJ, even though he was ostracized from most of the world, probably, he did have his little circle. He had his friends. He played golf. He made little silly Instagram videos.
And he had the bitches on him.
Yeah, he definitely had the bitches on
and
him.
And he had the bitches.
Bitches like danger.
Fucking the white bitches.
They like a little danger. You never know what you're going to get with OJ.
How do you kill a white bitch and then grab you a plethora of them?
It's the same way that like serial killers who kill women specifically, they have like women that write love letters to them. Yeah. It's like they
bitches.
Think, oh, I can make him change.
Yeah.
But
change it to your skin, toots. What the fuck?
Change you from living to dead.
I'll be honest, though. I never believed OJ would kill again.
You didn't think he would, because
he never married again.
He ain't have a target.
He was in prison. He was in prison for a good amount of the end of his life, right?
I'm just going to stay single. I think that's for the best.
Yeah, you know what? If I don't say I do not have to kill anybody.
That bitch was cheating. She had to go.
I'm actually really mad that Norm MacDonald died before OJ. because we're missing out on some really good jokes right now. Some real good material.
Oh, man.
Do you want to see OJ's last videos?
Sure, why not?
Little girl memorializing of OJ.
Oh my God, in memoriam. You got the angel song.
How do you think Ron Goldman's father feels today?
He's probably pissed.
He probably is.
Yeah, because
he wanted him to die in a fucking nasty, vicious way.
Yeah, and he just passes away in his sleep due to cancer,
with his loved ones surrounding him,
and half of the America saying, "Yeah, you know, he wasn't that bad of a guy."
Exactly. R.I.P. man. R.I.P.
R.I.P. Juice. What you mean, R.I.P. Juice?
What you mean, rest in peace?
That poor guy.
Peace.
He never got justice, that guy. Because nope. I don't think OJ ever paid him any money either, right?
Yeah, OJ never got justice.
Well, I thought they sued him for restitution.
I don't think he ever paid him.
Oh shit. Maybe they can get it from the estate now.
I heard what it was is that they weren't like the I think the stipulations were that they weren't allowed to take anything from his football pension.
Ah.
Yeah, so like anything he made after that. So maybe they got some Naked Gun residuals or something. He might be all right.
He might be all right. Yeah.
Naked Gun's a classic movie.
Hey, it's a great movie.
OJ doesn't ruin it for me. In fact, he's fantastic in it.
OJ's a highlight.
Yes, he is. Remember when he kept getting injured throughout the whole thing?
He kept getting hurt. The juice, man.
All right, let's
in memoriam. You don't got the in the Yeah, throw that on there.
Or I'll see you again.
Yeah, one of those sashes.
It's so hard
to say goodbye.
All right, this is him. I think this is one of his last videos.
Hey, X-World. Hospice? Hospice? You talking about hospice? No, I'm not in any hospice. I don't know who put that out there, but... whoever put that out there, I guess it's like the Donald Sink. Can't trust the media. In any event, I'm hosting a ton of friends for the Super Bowl here in Las Vegas. And all is well, you know? So, hey, guys, take care. Have a good Super Bowl weekend.
You know, he's such a good liar, I believe him. Yeah, and he's dead.
He went right to the hospital after this video.
Yeah. We got an IV strapped in the back seat right now, life support under the seat.
Oh my God. That's how
he was out of breath after the video.
That's how I know he killed that girl, because he lied with such confidence.
Like, he never breaks character, this guy.
He's
like a old wrestler from the 70s.
He doesn't break kayfabe.
He doesn't break kayfabe. Hospice. OJ don't got no cancer.
That's a fucking hospital right behind him.
That's a hospital ward behind him.
Yep.
I mean, that's, he doesn't crazy. Look bad for a guy dying of cancer. Let's be honest.
This guy ain't no hospital. I'm finna die at the crib.
Surrounded by my little ones.
I think this is his, legitimate last one. It's kind of long. We'll just play a little bit of it.
Ain't no hospice pool, I'll tell you that.
Nah, he had the hacienda.
You know how you know he's a liar? Is his laugh. Because he has that like, OJ, ain't nothing wrong with OJ. Yuck, 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 yuck. Like, it's not real.
Nobody laughs like that. He's faking the laugh. Yeah.
Yuck, yuck,
yuck. Hey, X-World, it's me, yours truly. Boy, what a beautiful day it is here in Las Vegas. Even though the game is indoors, it wouldn't have mattered, but still, it's nice to have a beautiful day like this. Hey, let me take a moment to say thank you to all the people who've reached out to me. My health is good. I mean, obviously, I'm dealing with some issues. But
cancer.
Hey, I think I'm just about over it, and I'll be back on that golf
course. Oh, my God.
Hopefully in a couple
of liar.
Weeks. But it was very nice hearing from you and hearing those good, positive words. Thank you. Now, as far as the game goes,
what a maneuver!
It's not hope.
That's
I'm basing
brain.
It on who's on the field. I see a 24-20 win by the 49ers.
Was he right?
Who won the Super Bowl this year?
What if he was dead on?
The Chiefs.
Dead on accurate.
It was the Chiefs. It was the Chiefs.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, he was wrong.
All right. Yuck.
Fucking OJ, man.
He's died of cancer.
He's dead.
He's dead. He's dead.
Hey, man, we can finally close this chapter. And it, can we have enough arguments from black people telling us he's innocent? Just say what it is. Y'all just wanted one over on white people. That's all.
That's all it was.
Just call it what it is. Yeah. That's it.
We won.
But, but if they do that, then doesn't that admit, like, that so? It's what? No, that would admit that they were wrong. They were lying.
Not to them.
Yeah.
Lawyers lie every day, B. We just follow what the lawyer said.
Yeah, but jurors aren't supposed to.
Yeah, jurors are supposed to just look at strictly at the evidence and not make their decisions off of racial biases.
I guess the other thing is that he was super famous. OJ was one of the most famous people
he was on Wheaties.
No, that's when he was starting to fall off, right?
No, Juice was always Juice.
Juice was always Juice.
Even after football. Hey, Juice, can I get your autograph?
Yeah, don't disrespect the GOAT.
You know he wasn't black. He was OJ.
Yeah, I know.
Yeah. That's one important thing I liked about him.
It's important. I'm not black, I'm OJ.
Yeah. All right. What else do we have here? So OJ's dead. And then we have another dead one, Dexter Reed.
Yikes. Another dead one. I just put that together. Oh, man. Yeah, now this one, it's a new George Floyd. At least they're trying. They're trying hard.
I don't think this one's taking.
It's not going to stick. But that's the picture they've been using.
Yeah.
Have you seen the mom with her theater? Oh my God.
She's amazing.
She's trying to get that check.
The fucking Democrat Party are like squatting on the board table, jerking off right now, watching her. Like, oh, she is gold.
Squatting on them. Why did I visualize that?
Like fucking monkeys. They love women like that.
Oh, shit.
So, yeah, here's the little angel at his, I'm going to say high school, but could be middle school graduation.
Oh my. That's high school, bro.
Only because,
nigga, that's all you had to say. We know.
Reasons. shot 96 times. Well, shot at 96. I don't know if he got hit 96 times.
96 in 41 seconds. 41 is impressive. Seconds.
And here's his mugshot.
Those cops had switches.
Those cops train every day.
Yeah.
Hey, it could have been him shooting too. They just said 96 shots fired.
Yeah, maybe. Yeah, you might be right. They might have just counted the casings. But I'm sure they know. I think the reason is that he had a different caliber.
Yeah.
Yeah. So they could probably tell right away.
Oh, he was pulled over for a seatbelt violation.
I'm going to actually push back on that. I don't believe it.
Well, I was going to say, even so, let's say he was, right?
Uh-huh.
So what? Put your fucking seatbelt on. Who doesn't wear their fucking seatbelt? Are you kidding me? You could have potentially saved your... Like, I don't understand why people who commit crimes or are committing crimes actively do everything to get themselves pulled over. They'll run stop signs. They'll run green lights. They won't have their seatbelt on. They'll have super dark tints. Everything. And they're doing shit wrong. Like, they're riding dirty. And then turn around and be like, all the cops is racist. Like, nah, nigga, you're riding dirty and you're stupid.
Well, not only that, this guy's out on parole right now for a weapons charge.
Oh, so he's a felon with a gun.
With an illegal gun, yeah. Because he's not supposed to have it.
Get the fuck out of here, bro.
Yeah.
Good riddance. They cleaned up the streets. Thank you.
This is the reason why I don't think it's about the seatbelt. Because when you see, we're going to play the body cam footage, and then we'll get to the crazy family. If you see when the cop walks up, she asks him right away, like, what are you doing? Yeah, like, so I think they were approaching him initially for something, like he was doing something illegal already, or it looks like he's parked.
Maybe
there,
he was just parked illegally.
Illegally or something, yeah. And that's why they were suspicious of what he was doing.
It does look like he's in the middle of a crosswalk right now, right?
Yeah, yeah. And also, one more thing before I play it. These are supposedly undercover, right? They're plainclothes cops?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. So I hear, though, they don't they don't do this normally. Like they don't actually do traffic stops.
Right.
So that also leads me to believe that it's not a traffic stop.
That maybe they were surveilling him in the first place.
There's something else, yeah.
Roll the window down. What are you doing?
Roll this one down.
Roll that one down too. Hey, don't roll the window up. Don't roll the window up.
Should I even show the rest?
You know, I think
like
it's important.
Show the actual shots?
I think it's important for you to know. I think it's important for you to see the first shot, which is important.
Yeah.
Because it came from one person, and that nigga's dead.
Yeah, yeah. Well, we're watching this for educational purposes, right?
Yes.
I think if we say that, then we're covered.
Sure. Yeah.
All right, but I won't show that. I'll just show the initial beginning of the shooting.
Do not roll.
And then we'll count to 96.
The window up.
He rolls the window down.
Unlock the doors now. Unlock the doors now. Open the door now. Open the door now. Open the door now.
So you can hear now it could be a sort of distance too that could make the sound different. Mm-hmm. You know what I mean? But mm-hmm. It sounds like two different calibers.
Well, you could actually
sounds like a lower caliber versus a higher.
You could see the muzzle flash from the window.
Right. Well, yeah.
So
that's another thing too.
I mean, but clearly,
it also, you know, it's just a dead giveaway of like that's why he was behaving the way he was, and it also means that the cops were right. And, you know, to be fair, let's just say that there could be an unconstitutional stop. However, I don't believe that's what was going on. I don't think we have the story, the full story.
Question, were any of them at the car at the time had a uniform on?
I'm not 100% sure because all I've seen is body cam footage and then footage from like distance. And you can only see figures. You know what I mean?
Because. Not just shooting a little bill here. If I'm driving down the street, well, honestly, I wouldn't be doing nothing illegal or probably in the middle of a crossroad like an idiot. But if anybody approaches my car with a gun out trying to open my door, tell me to get out. I don't see a badge.
I'm pretty sure they had their badges out.
I mean, yeah, that would be wild if they were just in plain clothes.
And I think they pulled up. let me pull it back because I think there are cars that have the lights.
Plus, you can kind of tell like who's a cop. It's not like it's another nigglet in front of him.
Well, I'm saying when I said something unconstitutional, that's kind of what I'm saying is like maybe is there a thing? I doubt it because I don't see it from any context. I'm just saying if there is context we don't have, mm-hmm. just to be fair, playing devil's advocate. But it's like if they that's not the law basically. You can assume somebody's a cop literally even if they're wearing a cop's uniform. They still have to identify themselves as a cop.
It's true.
You know what I mean? That's the law.
Did they ID? I don't think they ID'd.
But if they have their badges out and their
then they don't need.
Well, I don't know what their policy is. I guess different states have different policy.
Because if they're undercover or whatever the case is, they wouldn't have their badge just brandished out like that. Dead ass giveaway.
That's a good point, Mr. Randall. Do undercover cops have body cams too? Wouldn't that mean they're in uniform? If you can see the body cam, right? Regular people don't walk around with body cams.
Yeah, I mean. But again, you can't use that logic because there could be somebody walking around with a body cam. Okay. Yeah. So, but yeah, the fact that he seems to be parked illegally, he was obviously up to something. Like, I don't know. He has an illegal gun. He's not supposed to even have it.
Probably sitting waiting for an op. You know?
I don't know what he's up to, but
typical hood shit.
Yeah.
Well, I tell you what he's up to now, Chris. Not much. Not much.
Not much. you wanna see the family?
We got to, man, because
the family bug out.
Cause again, you know who the fucking bad ones are in your family, right? Like, you know that nigga did some bullshit. You like, and you raised him. So how you surprised now that he dead?
You know, I'm sorry. Or I was just thinking,
he's
though,
dead because she doesn't know anything.
I was just thinking, though, would like, even if the cops didn't, like, no, I'm wrong. I was just trying to think something. I was going to say, even if they didn't identify themselves, would that still be, like, okay for him to, did they pose enough of a threat? But they did have their guns out.
They had their guns out.
And trying to open the door.
Yeah. But I was just asking. All right, sorry. What were you saying about the crazy mom? Want to see her faint?
Yeah, because I feel like she's trying to get a check right now.
Of course.
Yeah.
That's what they all do. Mm-hmm. About his. Say nothing new.
Now, I'm sure she actually is, like, sad, right? I'm not going to take that away from her. Her kid's dead. But the amount of sadness that I think she's displaying is over the top.
I guarantee you.
Something that you know he did that shit, bruh.
This is why we do the segments we do. I guarantee you, this would be the same type of woman that would be twerking at her son's funeral.
Mm.
It's all about her.
Mm.
Yeah.
Still, wait a minute. What do you mean? What do you mean it still doesn't justify 90 chance? You're gonna have to explain that one, brother. Well, how much does getting shot at justify?
I think that's such a ridiculous argument. Is how many bullets? It was like, first off, cops are neutralizing a subject. They don't. They don't
neutralize your threat.
Yeah, exactly.
But that should be anybody who has a gun.
Yeah, multiple. You have multiple cops shooting at the same time simultaneously. Right. It went on for 40 something seconds. Like, what are they supposed to go? Oh, wait a minute.
Guys, I think we're at 40.
Yeah.
40. Fuck.
Fuck, we gotta wait 5 minutes. At 5 minute grace period, guys. Hold your fire.
Time out.
Let them shoot it out. You don't have to make it fair for them. Yeah. Let it rain fucking hellfire missiles down on that Negro. I don't care.
Hey, man, it is what it is.
Get home safe, fellas. Not to mention, also, the racial side of this, he shot at black cops as well. So it's suck a dick with the racial element. Better off going after the woman. All right.
He just bought his new car 3 days before that.
And he has been in it. Continue.
It's brand new, though.
Brand old new.
And brand new to somebody.
Old brand new.
Brand old.
He had just bought his new car 3 days before that. And he was just riding around in his car. He said, Mom, go for a ride. And they killed him.
They killed him.
I'm just going for a ride. Who does that?
It's a bit much.
Me.
No, he really said, I'm going to go ride on these niggas. That's what he said.
Finally got my whip, ma. Finally got on me, nigga.
Got to give my first homo.
Yeah, he got homoed, nigga.
Yeah, that's, I mean, he shot at them, ma'am. What do you want?
If you shoot at a cop, you're probably going to get shot.
Maybe you should have taught him that.
Hmm. Might have been a good lesson. But let his death be a lesson to others. How about that? Huh?
Maybe his father should have taught him that? Oh, bet you he's not there.
Nah, I'm sure he's there. Maybe he's one of those strapping young men behind her.
No, they look like community leaders. If you know what I mean.
He's there. His plot's right next to his.
In spirit.
Damn, his plot right next to his. Holy shit.
Jesus.
That was dark.
I don't know if that's true.
Yeah, I just can't.
Yeah, it's, I mean, I don't even believe she's sad. I'll be honest. I know you're not supposed to be presumptuous of people's feelings, but
I gotta believe that it's her son. At the end of the day, I still feel like she's probably a little sad. But I also think like she's hamming it up for sure.
But I also think she knows where her son went wrong too. So yeah. That's why it's a little bit of a.
It's denial.
It's not denial more than she's angry at him too for that being dead. But she's just going to say the cop shot at him because she knows the truth.
All right. Yeah, I see. Like when she's talking to her friends, she's like, I don't know why he had that gun.
The dumbass nigga. Exactly. You know what your son is out here doing, bro. All of them know what they.
I think they all knew. Yes,
and it's only a pride. My baby would never. He never did nothing. But you know exactly what the fuck he be doing.
She never said that.
I know she never said that. I'm just saying that's why I know she. That's commonplace.
All she said. He got a new car.
Do you think there's ever been one right that like? Because I believe a lot of it is activists and politicians that get behind them. They go visit them and they make them go like, oh wow, I got a real thing here, right? So they. It kind of motivates them to do. That's why they do it, right? Mm. Motivates them to keep the narrative alive. Do you think there's any one of them, any of these families that like sat back and went, "Do you think we're doing the wrong thing here?"
No.
Do you think we should just like
absolutely not
let this go?
Reparations.
He was wrong.
No, none of them.
And then that's where one of the family members go, "Rodney King, O.J. Simpson, come on, man, George Floyd, need I go on?
We've got to stick together." We all we got.
Yeah. Ain't just done.
Oh my God.
Ugh. So dirty that every time get, I say
that
it.
That one gets me every time. It's not justice. It's just us.
It's just us. Yeah. But I guess we'll keep up on that. Any riots going on from this yet?
Nah, because you know, I think
I'm gonna look that up while you talk.
I think it's over for the black criminal pity party. It's all about Hamas now. It's all about Hamas and the poor immigrants that are getting $9,000 a month stipends for just being here.
You could say that again.
Yeah.
How much?
$9,000. I was being hyperbolic. But
now it's all about protecting illegal immigrants and terrorists. I'm like, let's go back to protecting black folks.
Yeah. Yeah, that was better.
Making you guys look harmless.
At least it was just more contained, you know?
Yeah, exactly. All right. There doesn't seem to be any riots or anything.
Listen.
So good.
Hey, shout out to the officers. You guys made it home safe from another deranged person shooting at you.
I still don't know if they're in uniform or not.
Well, we don't have all the context, so that's why I was playing devil's advocate earlier, just in case there is context that comes out. You know, you gotta keep an open mind about all these things.
Yeah, but who do you think you are? Do you think you're Jason Bourne and you would just have a team of niggas running up on you and politely telling you to get out the car?
That's what I'm saying. Obviously, it seems to be.
You gotta infer. All right,
I'll give you an example. There's talks that they're saying. Some of the last shots that were fired, like there was a couple shots that you can see on camera. I don't want to show it because you know, you can actually see his body and stuff. Mm. They're saying that those last few shots may be deemed unnecessary or whatever excessive force. At that point, I think it's just like, all right, you're just nitpicking there.
Yeah.
You know what I mean?
Yeah.
So that's what I mean by this story may be where it is or it may continue. So, I think it is what it is, though. I think we probably won't hear about this again.
Doubt it.
Yeah. Oh, but you brought up Hamas earlier.
Oh, this psycho chick, bro.
Oh, you saw this?
Oh, my God. Yes, bro. What the hell? Who? Religion of peace. Religion of fucking peace.
The religion of peace, baby. They're a lovely faith-based.
I got a lot of problems with the shit she said. You might just want to play it because
I think everybody does.
She really fucking irked me.
Even the fucking libs had a problem with it.
Stick to Muhammad. Don't put Jesus in your mouth. Yeah. Fuck.
This is why they don't let you talk over there. fucking.
They don't even let you drive, toots. Be happy. The fuck?
Exactly. All right, so this is let me get her name so we know who we're talking about here.
Looks like a Patel.
It is a Patel, actually.
Oh shit.
It is a Patel.
It's like shooting fish in a barrel.
Ridhi Patel. Patel. That's the only way I can say that name right.
I remember.
That's the only way I know I'm pronouncing it right.
Ridhi Patel. You have to yell it from the goat cheese mountains.
Yeah. All right. And, yeah, I'm just going to play it because this is fucking ridiculous on its own.
I remind you that these holidays that we practice, that other people in the Global South practice, believe in violent revolution against their oppressors. And I hope one day somebody brings the guillotine and kills all of you motherfuckers. Regardless of whether you elect people into office, they'll backstab you, they'll let you die. And for that reason, you guys want to criminalize us with metal detectors, we'll see you at your house. We'll murder you.
Next speaker, please. Lance, followed by Kev, followed by Valeria.
By the way, there's like it almost seemed like they were gonna move right along, and then I think somebody calls that out.
That white lady. She was like, no,
that's a threat.
Yeah, that's a threat. The officers will head. Don't go nowhere. Those cops will be seeing you soon. Patel.
But again, though, like, I'm sure there's leftists that'll defend this, right?
Of course.
But why, when I say that they're violent revolutionaries and that they believe in violence to push forth their fucking religion.
You're being really xenophobic right now?
Exactly.
It's making me uncomfortable.
She's telling us. She's literally saying, I'm a terrorist. It's a nice way of saying I'm a terrorist.
You guys aren't pushing through the things that I want you to push through, so we're going to come murder you.
Yeah.
And put somebody else in place.
And oddly enough, she's talking about a violent revolutionary to fight oppressors. Your oppressor is your own fucking religion, you dumb fucking towelhead heeb.
Who, again, couldn't show her face in her nation.
Exactly.
Yeah.
Or her arms.
Or her arms, yeah.
Let alone that fucking nose ring. Maybe they do have one.
Yeah, they have nose rings.
Yeah, yeah. You just don't see them.
Could smell the curry from here.
Or the biryani.
Murder you.
Next speaker, please.
I feel like she walked off like she was supposed to get a thunderous applause to that.
Yeah, like that was brave.
Get the fuck out of here.
It was brave. And yeah, the person who just said, next speaker, please. Like, as if she just gave something of substance instead of a death threat, a direct death threat.
You know, I think the cops probably should have taken action on their own. You know, she said it in front of all of them, to be honest.
She committed a crime in front of police, yeah. Yeah. That's what is it called? It's probably a misdemeanor.
Terroristic threats.
Actually, it is terroristic threats. Yeah,
yeah. Yeah, that's fucking serious.
See, now this is somebody who should be looked at by the FBI. However, they're too busy looking for white supremacists.
And anybody who retweets a funny lib of TikTok about Joe Biden.
Or misgendered somebody the wrong way. Or showed up to a fucking parent-teacher conference and complained.
Kev? Followed by Valeria. Ms. Patel, that was a threat, what you said at the end, and so the officers are going to escort you out and take care of that.
All right, Ling Ling.
It's like Ling Ling had to hear it first. Like, it's a threat.
Now, was it's she,
a threat. No, I think she was trying to get their attention from the get-go.
Yeah, I don't think she was the one talking, was she?
No, she wasn't the one that said next.
She looked like she was talking, though.
Watch.
Next speaker, please.
Yeah, that's her.
Is that her?
Lance, followed by Kev.
I think she knew.
Lance?
This is what I think happened. She knew that that girl fucked up, and she was going to try to move on, and then when somebody called her out, she's like, fuck, I got to do it now. And that's why she was so quick with it. Like, she made it, like, really abrupt, like, so it wasn't too embarrassing for her.
Followed by Valeria.
Yeah, see, she's the one that called it out.
Ah.
Ms. Patel, yeah. That was a threat.
Shout out, Judge
what
Judy.
You said.
That's now fake anger. She wanted to try to protect that woman.
Yeah.
Yes, absolutely.
Okay.
And then when she basically got called out for not doing anything.
I didn't even realize that.
Yeah.
Holy shit. Okay.
That's why Krishan the Don loves and protects Karens. They tell on people.
The fucking tattletales.
She just told on a terrorist.
Bunch
That's
of
some
Randalls.
G shit.
That's crazy, though.
Well, yeah, that's insane.
Again,
eat a dick, Ling Ling.
A religion of peace. That's all I got to say. They keep proving it wrong every day. Every day.
Yeah.
Yeah.
And this is also why women need to be removed from politics.
Expeditiously.
And I think that's why we're also fucking protecting terrorists now.
I think we've been protecting them for quite some time, actually.
We've been creating terrorists. We haven't been protecting them.
Okay, that's fair.
Get it right.
Part itself.
Actually, I don't think we've been creating any terrorists. I think that's all bullshit. I think it's their religion. It's as simple as that. That's why every time you kill one, fucking 10 more sprout out. It's the religion.
It's like they're like weeds.
Yes.
All right, who's this?
There's the DEI thing. You know what? Yeah, since we're kind of still on that topic of broads.
Oh, hold on. Shout out to Lone Wolf Annie. He just followed us from X.
Oh, nice.
Yeah, and followed Thank us you. on YouTube. He said reply Dexter COPA has short video on their site showing his car driving up the block. Police stopped him and they came from the side street pretty quick, like they were looking for him. So you're right. The DTs were probably doing an investigation on him, and they approached him.
They probably finally found him.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
That's what it was.
Exactly. Thank you, Lone Wolf.
Yes, thank you.
Annie. Lone Wolf Annie. Okay, so...
Yes, this might be one of my favorite DEI videos.
Yeah, this has to start becoming a segment, some kind of DEI segment. We'll figure it out, but because it's starting to fail right before our eyes, or it's been failing, let's be honest, but we're starting to get the sort of, what do you call it? We're starting to see it.
The ripple effect
of, like, okay, here's a video here. Here's a video there. Oh, look, fucking bridge just collapsed. Look at that.
Oh, amazing. Shit. A fucking door flew off a plane.
There you go.
God damn.
So this is just now we talk about it all the time. When you get on a plane, you want your pilot to be nerves of steel.
Presentation.
Yes. Even if he knows that we're all going to die, I want him to be like, he's got to be the strongest motherfucker there. Mm-hmm. You get what I'm saying? I want Sully.
The fucking coldest pilot this side of the Mississippi.
And you want that person to be like that because you want to feel like you're in good hands, being helpless.
30 fucking thousand feet in the air.
In the air.
Yeah, true. It's true.
So I'm just going to play the video, but I want anybody that disagrees with us or disagrees with me on my sexism about how I don't think women should do certain jobs. I'm going to play this video and tell me if you would honestly feel comfortable flying on a plane with this person.
Behind the helm.
As your pilot.
Okay, if you don't feel safe, get off the airplane.
But this is your captain speaking, okay. But never like this.
I'll stop, and we'll fly the airplane. Don't worry, I'm going to let my co-pilot fly it. He's a man. Okay?
It's a total meltdown. The pilot boarded in her street clothes and addressed the passengers over the intercom. Passenger Pam O'Neill couldn't believe what was happening.
She said, let's take a vote. How many of you would like to take off now with me dressed as I am, or would you prefer that I take 10 minutes to get changed?
And let's be real, Pam looks like the demographic that should support her being a pilot.
Yep.
That's all I'm going to say about Pam.
But Pam's pissed.
Yes.
Pissed off Pam.
Made her miss the parade. She missed Burning Man because of this.
Cute little uniform. Then she started talking about her divorce and political candidates. Okay, and the minute she mentioned that, a gentleman stood up and just yelled, "Whoa, enough. You're scaring me."
Another passenger, Randy Reese, got up to leave.
My nigga like, yeah, hey, bro. Hey, bro, I'm getting off this fucking plane. And if y'all smart, y'all gonna get off too.
Get off too, because this bitch is about to kill everybody.
He looks back. That motherfucker right there is not real.
Yeah. That motherfucker is an alien. Oh, no. What was the thing that she said he was?
I can't remember.
Yeah. Shapeshifter? I forgot what it was.
Gave a running commentary on social media. Pilot also insulted a couple on board.
Did I offend you? Okay, so did I purposely offend you? I did. The answer is yes. Flight attendants, please disarm doors.
After 20 passengers insisted on getting off the United Airlines flight, the pilot quietly left the aircraft.
Okay, if you don't feel safe, get off the airplane. But otherwise, we can go.
Now she's walking off and going like, it's because I'm a woman.
They just don't understand.
They just don't want
to. Whatever the fuck, she was pissed at her man, and it took it out on everybody on that plane.
She said it.
Yeah.
She was talking about her divorce.
She's going through a divorce.
I think she went through a fucking mental breakdown.
Yeah, the courts probably didn't further her favor that day. So she was like, fuck it, I'm not putting on my uniform. I don't even want to be here.
I fucking hate men. Now, did you notice, though, she made it like where it seems like it's, she was trying to say that it's sexist that they wanted her to wear her uniform. You want to wear the cute little uniform. Like they didn't tell you to put on a flight attendant.
Do you guys want to get there early? We can leave now. Or yeah, I got to take 10 minutes and I guess I could put my uniform on.
Yeah. How about you have some fucking decorum? It's not a city bus.
Or, how about you just wear your uniform when you come to work? I've never seen a pilot that does not have a pilot uniform on, right? So
yes.
That would be weird if you just got out of your convertible and was like, okay, we here.
With the wings and the if I don't see those wings, I'm not going.
I'm not taking a jetty to go to fucking Kong Island. Like
it's kinda like the police thing we were saying. Like, how do I know you're not just some crazy bitch that commandeered the plane?
Exactly.
Identify yourself as the pilot.
He's got box cutters right now.
Exactly. Fucking, why is it always difficult?
Well, whoever that guy is, he got out.
Good for him. Having the balls.
Holy shit.
Don't blame him.
That plane never went anywhere.
It didn't say whether or not she got fired, huh?
Nah. They probably reprimanded her.
She had a meltdown.
She probably cried, and then,
I missed under so much pressure.
Yeah, exactly.
I've been working 80 hours a week.
Thomas still wants everything.
Meanwhile, there's some fucking dude that's been doing this shit for 50 years. Nerves of steel.
It's just another day for him.
Probably got divorced because he's been on in the fucking air too much.
Pay for her lifestyle.
Exactly.
Crazy.
Still doing his thing.
Oh, you'd be okay if I was a man?
No, I'd be okay if you were in uniform.
No. I would be okay if you were a man. I'm telling you, yes. Let's just be honest with them. I think we've been lying a little bit on our side. I've been the only one being honest. I'm gonna call everybody else out. It's absolutely because you're a woman. That's why I don't want you flying planes. It's absolutely because. Now, can we move on?
Sure.
Exactly. There you go. I just say that with gender. We don't want you to be cops. It's absolutely because of your gender.
That's true. That's true. Yeah. No more lady cops.
What, do you disagree with pilots?
Do
you think women can be pilots?
I've seen women pilots before. as long as they're not batshit crazy, they'll be all right. It's usually the big ones.
Have you ever seen a woman that's not batshit crazy?
Yes.
Your wife, but you have to say that. You're legally binded to say that.
I can't testify against her by law. Okay? By law. By law.
Wonder? Women pilots?
No.
No. Good. Yeah, back to...
It's a good... I just don't think... Maybe it's just because I feel like flying a plane is not that hard.
Really?
Yeah, I can fly a fucking plane.
It's really just take off, throw it on autopilot.
You gotta figure out what the dials, with the pressures, flaps, get them shits together. And yeah, just pull up, pull down. Come on.
Nigga, eat some dinner, you're fucking in Utah.
Knowing how to navigate.
Yeah, bro.
You can get lost in the sky.
Bro, you just go...
Just one centimeter.
You roll it
off.
Down and you...
Oh. Just 1 centimeter off, you're hitting another plane and shit.
Exactly.
Man, that's light work, man.
Know planes don't have no auto landing feature. You're actually falling from the sky.
Yeah, well, you're gliding gracefully.
And you're telling me you could glide gracefully a 747 easily. Easily.
That's lightweight, bro. That's light. I don't know. It's not that big of a deal, bro. It's just a plane.
He's at the point where he'll say anything to win this.
Yo, bro, I did
just
it before.
Fucking plane. Yeah, I did it. Shit this morning. That's how I got here.
I was playing flight simulator before I got here, man. It ain't that hard, man. Shit.
You know, on flight simulator, if you crash into the Twin Towers, they ban you for life.
Really?
Yeah.
I had no idea.
I'm about to buy it.
I think that's a little much, I'll be honest.
I'm going to stream it. Let's see.
You going to try it? Never play this shit again? But what if when, like, later in your life, you get really into Flight Simulator?
You'll never be able to play that shit again, nigga. Remember when you did that shit in 2024, nigga?
I'll do it on a hotspot.
You ever think that when you see Lifetime bans? Like, I don't give a fuck about it now, but maybe later I might get into it. I don't want to get banned.
Yeah. That's why I don't talk in Call of Duty lobbies. Fucking stupid. And side fucking note, I was playing with some fucking Mexicans the other day, and they were cursing up a storm in Spanish, but I'm sure they didn't get a fucking warning. No, the warning's only for English.
Yes. Yeah, fuck. American service.
Oh, I didn't even think of that.
It's fucking stupid.
And then sometimes I'll go on, I'll hear Russians and I'll hear fucking Japanese
people.
So
you have to go in there and be like, what a bomba clayado.
There you go.
Gotta get around. I got you.
I've never heard a Jamaican argue about getting banned from Call of Duty.
Not Jamaican.
Fire upon your ass. Fire upon your ass. Fire. More fire.
Maybe playing with their two PS4s connected. With the fucking
and
Wi-Fi.
They say their commands while doing it.
Left, right, dunk, oh, shoot, 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 shoot. Hell to. Grenade, boom. Anytime I heard a Jamaican on Grand Theft Auto, I would always find them on the map and then go to pick them up and do a really gay voice. Come on, baby. What? Oh, we hit. Oh, that.
Fishman.
Yeah, it's hilarious. All right. You want to keep talking about dumb broads?
Why not?
I'm getting worn out, but I'm going to...
The View?
As long as we ain't going to Kamala Land, I don't think I can take a trip there.
Oh, no.
No, we're going to The View.
Oh, this is fucking worse. Oh my God!
Now we had the
fucking rocket scientist Sonny Hostin over here,
bro. Is this Oprah and fucking
Sonny Hostin.
Wendy Williams' daughter or something?
She does look like Wendy Williams.
That's a good comparison. I think you should just play it and let the video speak for itself, and then we'll talk about it.
All right, she's talking about the eclipse and the earthquakes and all the things going on.
Makeup artist, when the earthquake was happening, she put her coat on and she was like, Jesus is coming.
I'm out.
I'm leaving. We've got a solar eclipse. She ran down the hallway.
The rapture is here.
The rapture's here. And then also I learned that the cicadas are coming.
Cicadas.
Although I love the first time in
cicadas.
Cicadas.
No, I'm calling them cicadas.
Cicadas.
That's a cicada, my nigga.
That's something you eat.
The cicadas are coming.
Two different times are coming.
The good cicadas and the bad cicadas.
But for the first time in many, many years.
No, every 17 years this happens.
Well, that's not what I read, but maybe, you know better.
I will say all those.
You also, by the way, do you see how awkward? This is why women suck at this kind of stuff. Talk shows, podcasts. You see how awkward it gets when they disagree? When they're just like trying to present two different pieces of information.
Those things together would maybe lead one to believe that, you know, either climate change exists.
That's more
or something
point.
Is really
or
going
earth is
on.
Returning. Earthquakes are not at the mercy of climate change. It's underground. No. It happens.
Makeup art.
I mean, Joy really, really pushed back there. I mean, nothing she talked about is at the mercy of climate change.
The fucking eclipse.
The eclipse.
What is? What does that have to do with the ozone layer, dummy? That's weird.
And then there is like a thing where, you know how they like make fun of Christians for being, you know, religious. There's like a lot of. I don't even know if it's even religion. It's almost like sun god kind of shit.
Celestial.
That's what I'm saying. It's like we've pissed off the universe. That's what, you know what I mean?
Yeah.
It's like you threw a tin can on the floor. You've pissed off the sun god. Now he's made an eclipse and
Mother Nature is sad.
The rapture. Yes.
The fuck.
Mother Nature weeps.
Climate change for earthquakes is a new one.
They're just,
but this is a thought leader in a lot of women's lives.
Well, that's the new thing. It's just blame everything on climate change. Everything.
Yep.
They've made arguments about like racism and climate change being like kind of intertwined.
Yeah, because of redlining, they don't put us in the spot where it would always rain.
You see what I'm saying? Yeah, there's always some kind of like
always fucking something.
Anything could be connected to climate change. But then it's just like anytime they bring up the weather. It's like when there's hurricanes in Florida. Could this be? Oh, there's going to be a superstorm coming, and then dumb fucks fucking leave the bottom of Florida because they've been tricked by the news. And then the shit calms down before it hits land. Like every time.
Every year we
until it doesn't, and they don't move. And they're fucked.
But then they're really not. Maybe some flooding.
Every year,
maybe some wind blows some stuff down.
Every year it's a. It's going to be the most active hurricane season of this century. And it's not.
But
well,
even
it isn't
so,
for us, but other parts of Florida do get it.
Yeah, but yeah. I'm not trying to downplay hurricanes.
Tampa got hit pretty bad not too long ago.
I'm not downplaying the strength of hurricanes. My point is that they've always fucking hit here. Like, ever since I was a kid, that's always been a thing every year. Even if they don't come, we get ready for hurricanes. And about every 4 years, 5 years,
we get a nasty one.
We get hit.
Mm-hmm.
It just is what it is.
We haven't got hit in a minute though.
Wilma was the last. Well, yeah, true.
Trina.
No, we got hit at.
Well, yeah, you're right. There was one after that.
Irma.
Irma was different.
Yeah. That wasn't too bad.
A lot of water.
That was the one that they tried to scare everybody with. That it was going to be a superstorm.
Yeah.
The only thing I was worried about was flooding.
It was a superstorm for the Northeast when it kept going.
Yeah, but that's because they don't usually get hit by storms.
They're not ready for that. Yeah. They're ready for ice and shit.
Yeah, they're not built for it.
Yeah, they're not built for tough.
Exactly. And those only happen, what, every like 80 years or something like that? Well, they kind of been happening more
they've
recently.
They've been happening, yeah.
Climate change. Hey, come on. Eclipse.
Earthquakes. Aliens.
Saturn's in retrograde. Climate change. Come on. Ever since we landed on the moon, we disrupted the climate change on the moon. The climate. We caused change there. A lot of space junk.
You still think we landed on the moon?
Absolutely.
You just don't want to take the dub away from America.
I don't want to take the dub?
Yeah.
Okay, I'll be fair and say maybe we didn't land on the moon when they said we did.
All right, that's fair.
But they've definitely been there.
Well, no, they've definitely been there for sure. I just don't think they got there when they said they did.
I do believe that they did probably find something, and that's why they didn't go back.
Well, they're trying to go back.
Anunnakis?
No, they're trying to. I think Elon said he's trying to put something up there.
Yeah.
I'll deny.
It just became about money at that point. It's like, we're not going to fund it again. It's like, remember in Apollo 13, that was one of the things. Mm-hmm. They were like, you made it seem like, you know, a trip to Ohio.
It's not.
Not a big deal anymore. Did you see, speaking of space stuff, maybe we could just get into this.
Oh, boy.
They made a discovery. NASA. Wonder, I know you're going to be really into this one.
Yeah.
Yes, this is it.
Really?
Yeah, go ahead and read that, Skrill.
James Webb Telescope detects light from a small Earth-like planet and finds it's missing its atmosphere. Okay, that's interesting. I mean, it's Earth-like minus the atmosphere. There's no life on that planet. That's, you know. That's
yeah, but they're saying they found, like, it looks like city lights.
Get the fuck out of here. What?
Yeah, that's what I guess maybe it could just be like magma. You know what I mean?
Right.
But let me see if I can find the part.
I think I see it. Astronomers use JWST's mid-infrared camera called MIRI to look for the planet's thermal emissions. Think heat-sensing Terminator vision. They found that TRAPPIST-1b is scorching about 450 degrees Fahrenheit, 230 degrees Celsius, about the temperature of an oven, and it's likely lacks an atmosphere. Okay,
Like it's unlivable.
That's what I'm saying. Yeah. It has no atmosphere. It has to be unlivable. That might be
part. Okay, so it's just fucking fire, and yeah,
it's like another Mercury.
Oh, that's gay.
Yeah, they just found another rock.
It's gay as fuck.
They keep finding more rocks, and that's another. Maybe that's another proof of God that it's just we can't find anything else.
Any other like tangible life.
You would think that with all the telescopes and as far as we can look, we would have seen something. We didn't see anything. It's kind of weird.
Yeah, you'd think we'd...
Maybe we are the center of the universe.
Well, what about, remember back in the day there was the... There was like some kind of pulse coming from somewhere out in space.
Yeah, it's probably an explosion. Another gas star burning
could
up.
Could be.
Yeah.
Just be like a space echo.
Yeah. It's like watching ghost hunters and they hear little whispers.
Yeah, but if it was like a pulse, like, you know, going at a rhythm almost, it seems electronic. It's like a wave kind of thing. Or what if it's like some kind of, you know, unnatural thing going on?
Who knows?
Yeah. Really? Wow. Space travel really doesn't interest black folks, does it?
I mean.
Are you interested in the Elon Musk stuff going on?
I'm always interested in. Okay. In Elon shit. Because he's forward thinking. I think he's going to push. I think he's going to push us into a renaissance of space adventure. Like, obviously not right now, but down the line, like his son, XYZ, X chromosome 3, like that nigga, when he has a son, then that person is going to push forward some more like space travel. I think they're going to make some shit happen. But in terms of, I have no interest in going to space. That's correct. I don't know if that has anything to do with my blackness, but I'm interested in space in terms of what's out there.
I think it's that there's like a missing exploration kind of need that black folks don't have.
We got to explore, Chris. 'Cause 400 years ago, we explode by force.
You want adventure? We just walk outside the house. Yeah. That's all we gotta do.
Oh shit!
Hold on, we got a request to look up Sheila Jackson Lee eclipse glasses. I don't know what this is, so we'll just go.
Okay, we'll just go with it.
Let's go with it. I don't think we really have anything big left. Oh, is this it?
Wait a minute. Did she look at it first before putting the shades on? You're not supposed to.
You know, there was a lot of that going around this time. I heard when people were like, I don't believe it. You could just look at it.
Alright. Nigga, have you ever tried looking at the sun, bro?
Well, you know, that would be a way. Like, let's say the eclipse, right? If you look at an eclipse, it actually gave you like superpowers. That would be a smart way to keep the public from looking and getting superpowers.
Getting superpowers? Okay. Yeah. Yeah.
Would you take that gamble?
No, because that's gonna burn your retina. That's a fact. You're looking at a sun. And the eclipse is not going to stay there for long.
How do you know? Have you ever looked at an eclipse and burned your retina?
No.
Exactly.
Now, let me. Are you going to take a chance like that on something that could be true? Think about it. If you burn your retina severely enough, you could go blind. So would you risk blindness for superpowers?
You know what? Next eclipse.
We risking blindness for superpowers?
We're going to be like what? 50-something, maybe?
Maybe.
Yeah.
I think it said 2042.
2042?
Somewhere around, yeah.
Yeah, I don't want to do the math right now, but let's just say we're 50-something.
We'll be old farts.
Yeah, I'll look at it. I'll do one eye. Maybe I'll get...
I could wear a patch.
I'm not sure if this is it, Lisa Marie, but I'm going to play this. If it sucks, it's your fault. Why is that so hard?
Where did the whistle come into play? What was the whistle for?
Is that a help? Like looking for help? I'm not sure if that's what she wanted us to play, but
help.
I guess she was trying to rectify the kids. It sounded like kids in the background.
Why couldn't she get them on? That was like so frustrating to fucking watch.
It was.
She never bent the edges.
Fuck.
She didn't bend the endings?
Yeah.
It's so simple.
Yeah, it's like. Oh, okay, she has to bend the corners, so if it...
Shit, she just kept...
Damn.
She just kept looking up like, oh, fuck, I'm missing it. But I can't get this shit on my face.
They said her speech is really good.
How come I should not work?
Oh, this looks like it. Hold on.
The question...
I don't want to know what it is.
Raw dog?
Yeah, we're going to go raw dog.
And that's why the question is why or how could we as humans live on the moon? Are the gases such that we could do that? The sun is a mighty powerful heat that is almost impossible to go near the sun. And that's why the question...
I'm perplexed.
I'm going to need to see her sources on that one.
You know? Well, I'm pretty sure it is what?
It just say.
Oh, yes. Things. Thank you. That should have been pulled out many times on this episode.
That's true.
Actually, you got to say it because you brought it up. No, you got to say it the way.
Bitches say.
No, you got to say, you know what I always say.
Oh, you know what I always say. Bitches say the dumbest things.
Hey, okay.
So the moon is made out of gases that we can, what, breathe in? She talking about oxygen?
Ain't it?
Hasn't that already been proven that the moon doesn't have a atmosphere?
Maybe she just wanted to be a scientist.
She made a statement in the question form.
I think they just put these dumb fucks out there. No, like, just go out there and talk about it. And they really don't know anything. What?
Filibuster. Make it up.
Just make it up.
Just make it up.
Who is this woman? I don't even know her.
I don't know.
I've heard the name. Sheila Jackson Lee.
I think she's a representative.
Probably. So I got to hear it one more time. I'm sorry.
And that's why the question is why or how could we as humans live on the moon?
Okay, first thing. Why is she saying the question is, like, has that been on, like, the tip of everybody's brain as of late?
Well, it was on the top of the agenda, Chris, if you had went to the meeting.
In 1970.
They're currently still trying to build the Death Star.
Yeah, they thought we were going to colonize the moon, but then they're like, well, there's nothing really here.
Which I think they should. I still think they should put a forward operating base on the moon. Why not?
I think so. Yeah.
That'd be cool.
Put a prison on the moon.
I swear to God, I was just watching Men in Black, and that's what they did. And I think that would be great.
That actually would be great.
Yeah. But it's like anybody that should have gotten the death penalty, if we don't want to do death penalty, send them to the moon.
Skip 4. You're dead.
Fuck them. Yeah, you're basically dead.
Are the gases such that we could do that? The sun is a mighty powerful heat.
Okay, now the sun is a mighty powerful heat. We do feel that from all the way down here.
Yes.
Earth.
It's almost impossible to go near the sun.
You don't say. I learned something new today.
Yeah. But it's questionable if we can breathe on the moon or not.
I don't know what this lady's talking about, man.
What the fuck?
She's up there.
Maybe she's saying we could turn the gas into breathable air.
And then use that breathable air to fly closer to the sun.
To blow the sun cooler.
Why would we go to the sun? Ever.
Because we get superpowers.
They trying to keep it from us. That's the only reason they fake the sun is hot. And it's really just a bulb in the sky.
And if you noticed, I think she was just faking that. With the glasses, she was trying to get superpowers. And she was trying to make it look like
she's trying to make it look something. That's funny.
Yeah, she's a lot smarter than we think. All right,
man.
Damn, I wish Kamala said that. What a good segment.
Oh shit.
It was Kamala like.
Nah.
The sun is hot. And it's impossible for us to go to the sun.
But the moon has these gases. Oh, shit. There it is. The cackle of Medusa herself. Jesus. All right.
All right.
I say we...
You want to wrap it?
Yeah, I say we get out of here.
All right. Do now one segment.
Yeah, I did have Can't Take Niggas Nowhere, but we'll save that again.
Yeah.
It's the sad one. I actually found it again.
You found it again? Yeah, stop putting that up.
We won't do it.
All right.
Let's just check out the chat real quick, and then we'll get out of here.
Chat was on fire tonight. Shout out to Lisa Marie, of course.
Darkman. Yes, of course. Lone Wolf Annie. Coming through.
Welcome to the show.
Keeping it live.
Misfit Ramdill. Brian Brumbolo. Young Chance, PA.
Procrastination Station, shout out to you. By the way, Procrastination Station, I did check out, I think he was the one that put this, Yellow Wolf, his diss track to, I guess, all the white rappers. Kind of annoyed me. I didn't really...
Yeah, I saw the comment too. I'm not the biggest Yellow Wolf fan. There's a lot of white rappers I'd put above Yellow Wolf.
I didn't like how he went after all his brothers.
Is that what it was?
Yeah, yeah. We gotta have some unity out there.
Why did he do it?
I don't know. It just felt like, yeah, that's the point. It just felt like he was just going after them to go after them. But like, why not just go after everybody?
Because they not white, Chris.
I can only
fight the white.
Birdman.
But then it was
I can't rap against the white.
But then it was also like him kind of like ball washing Shady a little bit.
You know he's always gonna ball yeah. wash him.
I get why. Don't get me wrong, but like,
put me on, man.
Yeah. Let's see. I feel like we may have missed somebody.
Birdman
back in the building. R.I.P. Orenthal James. Birdman.
I think that might have been it.
Yeah, I was just trying to read. Oh, Misfit Ranks. Shout out to you, brother. Kira Ora. Did you shout out Misfit Ramdale?
Yeah, I did.
Okay, good.
Rabby Ram.
I thought I saw Peter Ortiz in here.
I thought I did too.
Yeah, I might have missed him somewhere. He got lost in a shuffle. Oh, Darkman, did you say him?
Yeah, I did.
Okay. All right, cool.
Yeah, Peter was right there. Peter!
Oh, okay, yeah.
What's up, bro?
I knew I saw his name earlier. All right, guys. Well, we are going to get out of here. Before we get out of here, don't forget.
Like, share, subscribe.
Like, share, and subscribe.
Hit the Definitely. Bell. Get them notifications.
And I think while we're on air, we do. Thank you.
That's a good thing.
Ooh, chavo.
That's right. For shizzle.
I think we just hit 5,880 while we were on air.
Let's go. Yeah,
I think that might have been Lone Wolf Annie, who just jumped in.
Nice.
And we had a couple other ones, but shout out to you guys. We appreciate you.
Thank you.
Don't forget to follow us on Podbean. That's misfitnation.podbean.com. If you want the audio version of this show, just the audio version. Also, shop misfitnation.com. Go ahead and grab America's Most Dangerous merch from America's Most Dangerous Podcast, huh?
Hey, facts.
What else do we have? Our social medias, really X. That's probably the big one. If you're not subscribed yet, subscribe to the Misfit Nation on YouTube, Rumble, Odyssey. All of those great platforms that aren't YouTube. Yeah.
All right, cool.
That's it, right?
For you, duh. Oh. You gotta follow the Twitch, Skrillkill, SKRILLKIIL. Gonna be streaming tomorrow, so make sure y'all check it out.
You can follow me. I am Wonder, IAMWNDA on all social media networks. Also, follow me on YouTube at Wonderland. And follow me on IG, Trades Customs, TRADZ Customs with an S. Check out the website, Adda.com. Yeah.
Nice. And of course, you can follow me on X at Krishan the Don. Get on there. Really, that's the best way to reach me if you want to talk about anything of the show. Maybe you want to get booked, huh? Maybe you want to...
If you want to parlay,
yeah. Chat. And real quick before we go, we did bring back... Run.
Kayfabe! I could go over the whole damn Kayfabe Cartel.
Yes, ladies and gentlemen. We brought back our wrestling channel, nice. And it may go away just as quickly, but WWE's pissed us off. Go watch our last couple rants. They were pretty good, actually. We're in disagreement with most of the fans right now, so we'll see. But yeah, if you're a wrestling fan, you're a new subscriber. If you happen to be a wrestling fan, go over there and check that out. And that is all, ladies and gentlemen. Thank you so much.
Peace.
Bye.
Fuck off.
This episode of the Misfit Nation podcast is over. But that doesn't mean the conversation has to end. So if you're not a socially awkward queer, follow us on Facebook, Instagram, or at the Misfit Nation. Also, help us prepare for our inevitable YouTube ban by following us on alternative platforms like Rumble and Odyssey. At the Misfit Nation. And if you're tired of looking at our ugly mugs, you can listen to the audio version of the show on Apple Podcasts or Podbean. That's misfitnation.podbean.com.
best chance.